Well, good evening, everyone. We're back here on this beautiful Tuesday evening. We do apologize. We had some technical issues with the server, but we do apologize. We up and running, and we thank God for you and your family for tuning in on this Tuesday revival, fire revival, each Tuesday at 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time and 8 o'clock Central. So once again, we do apologize for the server that was out of our control, but we back in effect, and we thank and praise God for another Tuesday night that we're here on this beautiful revival night. Amen. So without further ado, we're going to let our radio host for this evening share, amen, before we have the man of God to come up and bless us on this evening. Amen. So come on, put your hands together for Minister Robbi Williams. God bless you.
Good evening. This is Minister Robbi Williams, and I am your host for I Am Built for This Ministries. I am so excited on the move of God concerning the great revival that has begun on last week. The Holy Ghost Fire Revival. Last week, we heard a powerful word from Pastor Valissa Moore. And this week, we're going to be hearing from Pastor David Moore. So sit back, relax, and hear the man of God. See you next week. Much love.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to I Am Built for This Ministries, founded by Minister Robbi Williams. My name is Pastor David Moore, also known as Pastor D of Reaping the Harvest Christian Church in Garner, North Carolina. I want to thank Minister Williams for the invitation, and I thank God for the opportunity to share his word. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for your grace and your mercy. We thank you, Father God, for another opportunity to share your word with your people. We thank you, Lord, for your son Jesus and what he did for us on the cross. We're praying tonight, Father God, that something will be said that might draw people closer to you, that you might be glorified and that your people might be edified. We thank you, Lord, for blessing us to be a blessing. We thank you for great health, and we thank you for long life. It is in your son Jesus the Christ's name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. After my beautiful wife, Pastor V, brings us a musical selection, we'll dive right into the word. Amen.
Understanding wounds and bruises, stripes had set me free. Calvary was where you shed your blood just for me. I understand it now, that's why I walk in victory. Yeah, walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory. Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory. I used to see myself contrary to how you see me. I held to lies that hindered me from my own destiny. But what I've learned is I am fearfully and wonderfully made in your image. And that I am free. Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory. Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory.
Burdened down with memories past that tried to bondage me. Hiding fears, resentment, all contained inside of me. You showed me those were traps. Those traps were setups just for me. But Jesus Christ, my Savior, died and rose to set me free. Yeah. Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory.
Walking in victory.
Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory.
Yes, I'm free.
Walking in victory, walking in victory, walking in victory.
Walking in victory.
Walking in victory. Yeah. Walking in victory, yeah, walking, yeah, in victory,
yeah. I'm free,
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 I'm free.
John 14:26, and Jesus is speaking, and he says, "But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things, and will remind you of everything I have said to you." Tonight, we simply want to talk about the Holy Spirit. I've often heard people refer to the Holy Spirit as a small, still voice, as an it or something. Let's be absolutely clear tonight. The Holy Spirit is a person. As a matter of fact, he is a part of the Trinity. We have God the Father, the creator of everything, Jesus the Son, whom all things were created through him, and the Holy Spirit, the one that shows the power of God. He is the one that does the work or the heavy lifting. He's what we call the muscle, waiting to carry out God's word. You see, the Holy Spirit came upon Elijah, and he was able to outrun the chariot of Ahab. The Holy Spirit took Jesus to the wilderness and gave him the power to resist the devil. When Jesus was buried in a borrowed tomb, it was the Holy Spirit that raised him from the grave. You see, my brothers and sisters, from the beginning of time, the Holy Spirit was moving upon the surface of the water in the book of Genesis to right now, helping the believers by comforting us, guiding us, and teaching us. If you want to be revived tonight, my brothers and sisters, seek out the Holy Spirit. You see, throughout the Bible, the Holy Spirit was always working. Scripture tells us that John the Baptist was full of the Spirit in his mother's room. The disciples were filled with the Spirit in the upper room. And Peter, filled with the Spirit, stood up and preached on the day of Pentecost. Young Stephen was filled with the Spirit, and he saw the glory of God when he was stoned. And even Apostle Paul was inspired by the Spirit, and he rebuked a sorcerer. You see, my brothers and sisters, in John 14 and 26, in the Greek, the word Holy Spirit is known as the Parakletos, which means he is an advocate or an helper. Jesus said in John 16, 7 and 8, I tell you the truth, it's to your advantage that I go away, because if I don't, Parakletos, the advocate, the helper, won't come. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, the Holy Spirit, that is, your life will never be the same. You see, before Christ's death, the Holy Spirit came upon people, supplied the power of God so the task could be completed, then returned back to the Father. After Jesus' death, 1 Corinthians 3 and 16 lets us know that we are God's temple, and that God's Spirit, the Holy Spirit, now dwells within us when we accept Christ as our personal Lord and Savior. The Holy Spirit is a source of revelation, a source of wisdom, and a source of power. 1 Corinthians 2, 10 and 11 lets us know that the Holy Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. In other words, everything that God knows has been revealed to the Holy Spirit. That means, my brothers and sisters, we have access to the Creator. We, in other words, are geniuses. Why? Because everything the Holy Spirit knows, we now have access to it. You see, the Holy Spirit was sent to the believer because the Father knew we would need someone to supply us with his wisdom and power to carry out the mission, and that is to reconcile the people back to him. When the Holy Spirit becomes part of you, he brings the spiritual gifts with him. 1 Corinthians 12, 7 through 11 tells us that those gifts are the gifts of wisdom, the gift of knowledge, the gift of faith, the gift of healing, the gift of miraculous power, the gift of prophecy, the gift of discernment, the gift of speaking in tongues, and the gift to interpret tongues. And all these gifts come from the Holy Spirit. And all born-again believers receive a gift determined by the Spirit. These gifts are not for you, but for the good of others. Yes, my brothers and sisters, who is the Holy Spirit? Ephesians 1 and 13 tells us that he is a seal. In other words, when we accept Christ as Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit is our deposit or our seal or our mark of guarantee that we belong to the Father. The Holy Spirit makes believers new and gives them eternal life. Romans 8, 10 through 11 says, but if Christ is in you, then even though your body is subject to death because of sin, the Spirit gives life because of righteousness. And if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of his Spirit that now lives in you. I know you might be asking the question, how do I know I have the Holy Spirit? Well, just like anything else, there should be some evidence, and that evidence is the fruit of the Spirit. Galatians 5, 16 through 21 tells us to walk by the Spirit and not by our flesh. In other words, walk a holy life and not a sinful one. That evidence you see should be of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You see, my brothers and sisters, the question I have for the born-again believers tonight is, are you allowing the Spirit to work through you? Are you letting the Spirit guide you? Are you letting the Spirit comfort you? Are you allowing the Spirit to teach you? Are you allowing the Spirit to help you in every area of your life? You see, the majority of believers walk around daily being flesh-led instead of being Spirit-led. And it's sad. It's really sad when you have someone living inside you, the Holy Spirit that is, and years pass by and you never get to know each other. You never have that conversation and introduce yourself to the Spirit and allow the Spirit to introduce himself to you. If you allow him to introduce himself, he would probably tell you this, that he is a comforter, that he's a counselor, that he's a teacher, that he is the Spirit of knowledge, that he's the Spirit of truth, that he is the Spirit of life. He can tell you that he knows everything that God knows. He will tell you that because Christ is your Lord and Savior, he is now connected to your spirit. And because the Spirit is connected to you, you both are now roommates in the same earth suit, which is your body. He would tell you that you will never be alone another day in your life. Yes, my brothers and sisters, he would tell you that he is the Parakletos, the Counselor, the Comforter, the Spirit of Might, the Spirit of Glory, the Spirit of Truth, the Spirit of Life. Yes, he is the Holy Spirit. God's word for everybody. Amen and amen. If there is someone amongst us tonight that would like to get to know the Holy Spirit, then the first thing you got to do is accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. In order to do that, just repeat this salvation call after me. Heavenly Father, I am a sinner, and I ask that you would forgive me of my sins. I believe that Jesus is your Son. I believe that he hung on a cross, that he was buried in a grave, and that he rose again. And now I ask you, Jesus, to be my Lord and Savior and come into my heart, so that the Holy Spirit can come and connect to me. In Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen and amen. Once again, thank you all for joining us this evening on I Am Built for this ministry's broadcast, founded by Minister Robin Williams. Again, my name is David Moore, Pastor David Moore, or better known as Pastor D, of Reaping the Harvest Christian Church in Garner, North Carolina. We bid you a good night and God bless.
Forever, how long? Forever.
never thought I'd be. More humble, you humble me. But I'm not giving up. I'm not giving in. In Christ I do
shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my Elohim, in Him will I trust.
You said you never leave me or forsake. Take this fragile heart, take the pain away. In your presence is fullness, in your presence.
Everything will be fine in due time because of Yahweh. As I partake of the bread and wine, He will absolve me. Jesus Christ, the bread of life and the perfect sacrifice. Save me from this present life and the burning afterlife. Don't be feeding on the devil's pie, better reject the slice. Don't be mesmerized by wise lies from wise guys. Magic by the media, mad lies they're feeding you. Why you think they on your team? That's just when they start beating you. And defeated in this life means the fire will be heating you in an eternal flame that burns like the tail of a meteor. You won't find the truth of the world on Wikipedia. I spit the truth through verbs in the booth so the devil stops leading you into deception. Believers worried about the election. Stop putting trust in man and stand on God's word for protection. Abide under Yah's wings, He's the King of the resurrection, the Lord of everything, our only spirit.
In your presence is joy. It's alright, it's okay, cause of Yahweh. I'm alright, I'm okay, cause of Yahweh. It's alright, it's okay, cause of Yahweh. I'm alright, I'm okay, cause of Yahweh.
Hey guys, that is our time. We want to thank you for tuning in to Fire Revival for the month of April. You've been listening to I Am Built for This Ministry radio show, which your host was Minister Robbi Williams out of Garner, North Carolina. But we want to thank and praise God for all you listeners out here. Now do me a favor. Do me a square. Hit that share button. Invite your friends, your neighbor, and all your family to tune in to the best gospel radio on internet in America and across the land. That's right. The TMA radio broadcast of I Am Built for This Ministry radio show. God bless you and meet us back here the same time next week, 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 8 p.m. Central. We pray the blessings of the Lord in all your life and know that with Him, all things are possible. God bless you.